你好，欢迎收看六十分钟看美国，这个特别为你制作的电视周刊节目。这个节目呢，我会从美国的衣食住行各个方面向你全面介绍美国的生活方式。美国的生活方式其实蛮有意思的，有的东西呢其实是值得我们借鉴，用来建立一个属于我们自己的生活方式，一个更好的生活方式。好，你给我六十分钟，我带给你美国。漂亮的衣服人人爱穿，有名的衣服呢贵了点，但是呢穿起来的感觉啊就是不一样。在纽约有个地方呢叫 Henry Bendel， 这地方专卖有名的设计师的衣服，今天我们的朋友就会带你去看一看。Come my lady, come my lady, you're my butterfly, sugar baby. Come my lady, come my lady, you're my butterfly, sugar baby. Such a sexy, pretty little thing. This April bitch, you got me sprung with your tongue ring. And I ain't gonna lie, cause your loving gets me high. So to keep you by my side, there's nothing that I won't try. Butterflies in her eyes and her looks to kill. Time is passing, I'm asking, could this be real? Cause I can't sleep, I can't hold still. The only thing I really know is she got sex appeal. I can feel, too much is never enough. You always there to lift me up when these times get rough. I was lost, now I'm found, ever since you've been around. You're the woman that I want, so you're putting it down. Come my lady, come my lady, you're my butterfly, sugar baby. Come my lady, you're my pretty baby, I'll make your legs shake, you make me go crazy.
位于纽约曼哈顿中城，以地皮昂贵、名店云集而著名的第五大道上的名店 Henry Bendel， 不仅是纽约最时髦、最名贵的商店之一，也是世界级的高级名牌店之一。Henry Bendel 的橱窗里陈列着世界顶级设计师设计的各种最新最应季的时装，代表着时装潮流的走向，与色彩绚丽和漂亮时尚的五大道交相辉映。维尼和他的先生来自加州，拥有两家时装店。他此次的纽约之行是看看纽约最新的流行时尚是什么， Henry Bendel 自然是他的首选了。
So characteristic of New York department store to be cluttered. Wax and a candle.
This is a huge part of the market now, accessories and hair accessories. Only in America would someone pay $25 for this plastic.
Henry Bendel 从名牌化妆品、各种头饰到漂亮时装，应有尽有，完全是一个女人的购物天堂。而光顾在这里的顾客多是有钱时髦的时尚追求者，他们对物品高昂的标价仿佛视而不见。在这里购物，买的是奢华的气氛、时髦的感觉和走在潮流尖端的优越感，而这一切已不是用金钱可以来衡量的了。
Vintage like turtles. And then, yeah.
面对漂亮时髦的名家时装，维尼掩饰不住跃跃欲试的冲动。无论如何，试衣服是不用花钱的，更何况 Henry Bendel 的试衣室提供给顾客一流的舒适，不管你买不买衣服，你都可以享受到这种贵宾式的待遇。经济五彩缤纷的时装将维尼打扮得多么漂亮啊。
Yo soy un hombre sincero, dijo Martí, de donde crece la palma. Y antes de morir me quiero cantar mis versos del alma.Sugar mama, come and dance with me. The smartest thing you ever did was take a chance with me. Whatever tickles your fancy, girls, me and you like Sid and Nancy. So sexy, almost evil. Talking about butterflies in my head. I used to think that happy endings were only in the books I read. But you made me feel alive when I was almost dead. You filled that empty space with the love I used to chase. And as far as I can see, it don't get better than this. So butterfly, here is a song and it's sealed with a kiss. And a thank you, miss. Come and dance with me.Come my lady, you're my butterfly, sugar baby. Come my lady, you're my pretty baby, I'll make your legs shake. You make me go crazy. Come my lady, come my lady, you're my butterfly.
Winnie 和他的先生也是爱表族，而这里陈列的手表都为昂贵的名牌，每一款价格都在$5,000以上。
You're my butterfly, sugar baby. Come my lady, you're my pretty baby, I'll make your legs shake. You make me go crazy.
流行的服饰，时尚的装潢，完全满足了 Winnie 此行的目的。其实在有意思的地方逛店浏览比买东西更具刺激。
你看，这里就是 Tavern on the Green， 全世界很有名的一家高级餐馆。在美国吃的地方很多很多，很多地方都很有名，但每一个地方有名的原因呢也都不一样。今天啊，我要给你介绍一家下城的有名的地方，叫 Time Cafe， 和这个呢完全不一样。
永远充满活力和动感的曼哈顿下城苏侯区 SOHO， 是纽约这个大都市的一面领导时尚潮流的旗帜。不管是在艺术文化还是在吃穿文化方面，苏侯区永远走在时代的尖端，就像这家叫做时代咖啡的餐馆 Time Cafe。
这个在夏天的时候，大家坐在外面吃，天开始热了，桌子也搬出来了，但还没开始吃呢。这叫 Time Cafe， 时代咖啡。当然，他们最不好喝的就是咖啡，最好吃的倒是他们的饭。
Time Cafe 时代咖啡。顾名思义是时代的倒视镜，从装潢的优雅到设计的时髦，反映着苏侯区的惯有的气氛和那种别出一格的文化品味和特征。
Our pasta special. It's bow tie pasta with artichoke, sun dried tomato, toasted garlic, and parmesan. It's really, really good. We also have a quiche special. Fontina cheese, bacon, and beef. The pasta special. You will like it. It's really good.
Okay. Can you put the cheese on the side? The pasta doesn't have cheese.
餐厅的服务小姐在为客人介绍着当日的头牌菜。我现在吃的是餐厅在上菜前免费提供的各种面包。
别看这面包里面一点味道都没有，但是一蘸了这个油以后，奇好吃无比。平常呢油没这么多，只给你一点点，可能很金贵。今天呢，看我们饿的眼睛发直。发绿，所以赶快给我们一大盘，希望我们别饿坏了。Oh, that's nice. Thank you. 这个是油炸鱿鱼圈，哦，要加点柠檬酱。先把这个搬到边上，你就看到了。吃呢是这样吃。哦，这是我在纽约吃过的所有这些鱿鱼油炸鱿鱼圈里最好的一个，他们自己也这么认为。
来时代咖啡就餐的客人们都是苏侯区常见的时髦人士，他们寻求的是像时代咖啡这种代表苏侯区餐厅特别营造出的时尚气氛和感觉。这就是时代咖啡代表菜之一的牛排汉堡，8.99美金一个，非常的实惠，尤其是牛排烤得鲜嫩爽口。配上番茄酱或芥末酱，味道好极了。时代咖啡也开始有亚洲客人光顾，大概是穆奇在苏侯区的美名吧。时代咖啡还为客人免费提供各种各样的时尚杂志，以满足大家在喝酒和等菜时的闲情逸致。意大利菜是苏侯高尚时髦的餐厅都会有的菜肴，像这道意大利面点，味道清淡，口感好，非常适合讲究品味的苏侯人吃。酒吧是时代咖啡时髦人士的最爱，到了晚上，这里年轻的酒客云集，非常热闹。像中午时分到这里坐着喝一杯的人士，基本上是苏侯区时髦的游人过客。在时代咖啡上班的服务生大多是年轻的演员，在这种时尚的地方打工，不过是成名之前的谋生手段而已。纽约未成名的演员大多在时髦的餐厅做服务生，对他们来讲，这大概是接触时尚生活最近的形式之一吧。这是最后的一道餐，冰淇淋甜点。我们来看看这道甜点做工及味道是怎么样的。
So good. Brownie 呢是纽约最有名的一种甜点，加上巧克力，加上香草冰淇淋，你想想这有多好吃。吃好了还要带一包回家，慢慢吃。Thank you.
Bye-bye, you're welcome.
出门前还可以看看门口的免费赠送的明信片，又有什么新品种了？ 怎么样？这时代咖啡给你留下的印象如何？如果你有机会到大名鼎鼎的苏侯区来，会不会也到这著名的时代咖啡品尝一下呢？
在美国，大家的一半时间呢都在汽车里度过。在美国横穿美国，开车横穿美国是非常有意思的事情。在我们这个节目呢，我们会开车横穿美国，带你看一下美国各种不同的景色和各种不同的人文风情。好了，你会喜欢的，我相信。好，再见，我们去逛美国。开车横穿美国需要计划周全，首先要在地图上设定一条要走的线路，因为从西海岸到东海岸的公路干线上下一共有好几条，穿过不同的州和城市。决定了线路之后，最好再到 3A 俱乐部领取有关的旅游书籍。 3A 俱乐部是专门为驾车人开办的，一年只要交几十块钱的会员费，就可以加入俱乐部，得到许多免费的资讯和帮助。你看，这么一大堆的书籍和地图都是他们免费提供的。还有一个 3A 俱乐部最好的好处是，如果你的车在任何地方坏了，他们都会免费来帮助你。我们这次横穿美国的线路选择的是从西海岸的加州的洛杉矶到东海岸的纽约市。
这个 Santa Barbara 是美国非常特别的一个小城市，这里呢住着很多有钱人，特别是这些洛杉矶的电影明星啊，他们最喜欢来这里安家了。因为这里呢离洛杉矶又很近，但是呢又没有洛杉矶那种喧嚣的闹市的那种感觉。那很多电影呢也都是在这边拍的，有一个电视剧就叫 Santa Barbara。
Santa Barbara 海岸线绵延起伏，拥抱着市容整洁的城市。这就是 Santa Barbara 的旗帜，在城市街道的上空高高飘扬。Santa Barbara 一年四季温暖如春，气候特别像中国的昆明，即便是二月的寒冬，这里也是桃花盛开，暖风袭人，一片春意盎然的风情。许多露天咖啡馆和餐馆供游人们坐下来喝杯咖啡，享受一下明媚的阳光。这是城市中心的一个商场 Shopping Mall， 环境布置得非常漂亮，充满了浪漫的欧陆风情，可不像商场区那种人头涌动的拥挤。 闲的气氛、浪漫的感觉和美丽的风情，构成了 Santa Barbara 整个城市的妩媚。
来自 Santa Barbara 度假真是一个非常不错的主意。这地方呢，尽管价钱贵了点，像住的地方呢，从70到100不等，但呢，我总觉得这地方实在是值这个价钱，因为这地方非常非常漂亮，而且人呢都非常有那种安居乐业的感觉。
离开了 Santa Barbara， 沿着洲际公路向东飞驰，展现在你眼前的是广阔的天空与山峦。不久，我们发现了一个 Madonna 酒店 Madonna Inn。它离 Santa Barbara 有几个小时车程，它可是一个不容错过的景点。虽然叫 Madonna 酒店，可是与著名歌星 Madonna 没有任何关系。它是一家有着十几年历史的老酒店，是由一对从事建筑装潢设计的夫妇一手设计修建的。浓郁艳丽的色彩，没有一点媚俗感。酒店内的洗手间很别致吧，连地面上铺的瓷砖都是定做成色彩丰富的鲜花图案。酒店还养了几只小白羊，大概是根据圣经里的典故而制造了中世纪的氛围和情调吧。只要把1美分的硬币投进这家特制的机器，就会出来一枚印有花纹的仿古硬币。麦当娜酒店受到许多名流的光顾，可以说它是美国西海岸一个富丽堂皇、风情独特的度假好地方。
看见美女就想入非非，是很多男人常常遇到的事情。那如何把只会讲英文的美女吸引过来，但是同时又不因为这个语言的障碍而使得自己丢人现眼呢？那下面你们将会看到的。
Hi.
Hi.
You are copying.
Yep, I'm copying.
Is this a good machine?
Yeah.
I have a very good machine, a computer.
Really?
Yes, I can make website on my computer. You need a website?
No, I don't need a website.
Oh. Happy copying.Hi.
Hi.
Would you like to have dinner with me in Chinatown?
You are barking up the wrong tree. You are barking up the wrong tree.
Barking up the wrong tree 的意思呢，不是说狗叫错了树，而是说你找错了门。当美女告诉你你找错门，那是什么意思呢？那就是你呀、啊、根本没戏，别再浪费时间了。
Hey.
Hi.
So that's your new computer.
Yes.
Well, the system's down. Do you mind if I borrow it for a bit?
You are barking up the wrong tree.
美丽的爱情故事大家都非常喜欢听，非常的感人，但是呢非常悲痛的这些离婚的故事呢也每一天都在发生。今天的社会这样繁忙，工作都很紧张，很多事情都在发生，还有没有像我脚下这样大岩石一样坚强的、坚如磐石一样的感人的爱情故事呢？有的，下面我要给你介绍的一个就是这样感人的故事。
我们的故事发生在一个名叫 Canal 的美丽温馨的小镇上，离喧闹的大城市洛杉矶不远。这是二月一个醉人的星期六的下午，直到我们来到一幢可以俯视整个 Canal 镇的房子前，才发现好像有什么不同寻常的事要发生。激动人心的时刻就要到来了，人们忙碌地为一个婚礼做着准备，想给主角们一个惊喜。可主角们不是要结婚，因为他们已经结婚了。感到奇怪吧？我们的主角 Tom and Lynn 实际上已经结婚30年了，有两个已经长大成人的女儿，其中一个刚为他们生下了第一个小外孙。这对夫妻搬到 Canal 小镇不过才1年，但他们的人品已经给周围的邻居留下了很好的印象。一个从事音乐制作的邻居 Chantel 决定为他们举办一个特别的庆祝会。
Lynn and Tom, they inspire us in a sense where, you know, a lot of people get married, a lot of people get divorced, a lot of people still stay married for a long time, but they're not still in love. And if you look at Tom and Lynn in their eyes, you can see they just love each other. Everybody was so excited about celebratingTom and Lynn and tell them how much we love them.
要举办这么一个让人吃惊的庆祝会，毕竟是有挑战的，特别是为就住在隔壁的邻居。
It was a surprise. It's to figure out how we would take them out and to be on time. We had her cousin to take them out for brunch, so we had between 3 or 4 hours to set upEverything without them knowing. That was the hardest part because, you know, we did it in front of their house, so we couldn't do anything before them going away. So we wait and we couldn't wait for them to get out of the house. And as soon as they were out of the house, we just run and, you know, put the flower, put the rug, put the candle. And I had to finish the cake also because I couldn't finish that cake too early because it's a special cake that you cannot do in advance.And I had to hide the fact that I was doing a cake, so I told Lynn that I was doing a dessert for a friend because I was going for dinner somewhere. You know, mostly what we try also is to have them dress because we didn't want them in jeans when they arrived, so we told them to dress a little bit. That was hard.
Tom and Lynn, 是否感到吃惊呢？
It was an absolute, total surprise.
It wasn't real at first. I came around and there were all those people and I could hear the wedding song playing and everyone yelling and clapping. And it connected in my brain somehow that this was for Tom and I.
And I immediately said to Lynn, because she's been known to do things of this nature before, I said, did you know about this? And lo and behold, she also didn't know about it. And I was really working on maintaining my composure, of not losing it. Of course, Lynn didn't do so well there. She immediately lost hers. And it was very touching, just the fact that all these people living around us who we have actually only known for a little over a year would think that much of us to go through all that trouble.
Tom and I were both deeply, deeply touched by it. And to know that that many people care that much about us to do what they did was just overwhelming.
They covered everything down to the last detail. I was totally surprised to see the tent. I thought, where the hell did they get this tent?
虽然很简朴，但整个仪式却非常感人和温馨。
Tom and Lynn, you have been on a journey of marriage together for 30 years. It is good to see two who are still together for so long, still loving and living and being happy together.Marriage is an institution both magnificent and holy. It is the foundation of the family, and hence, it is the foundation of society. Marriage is a process. It is the soil and climate in which two can flourish, far superior to what either could achieve alone. It is a mystery, as you have discovered. And as you continue to journey together, the mystery continues to unfold.
在现今这个瞬息万变、价值取向与过去大不相同的世界里，究竟是什么使这对夫妻将他们的婚姻关系维护得这么成功呢
？She always thinks of me ahead of herself, and I try to do that with her, but I'm not as good at it as she is.
He just is a very, very kind person. He has a very good heart.
I think part of it is you simply.Have to enjoy that other person's company. And I enjoy Lynn's company.
To say when you're first married, I couldn't love you any more than I do now is not a true thing to say, because after 30 years, the love does continue to grow. And it's still growing.
The secret to a long marriage is probably first and foremost is commitment.
Very often you see one of the other person in the couple put it down or do bad remark, or you will never have that with Tom and Lynn. They just support each other all the time. They just complete each other.
应当说，在这里举行的不仅仅是一场第二次婚礼，对大多数的西方人来说，这是对婚姻誓言的再一次允诺。
You may now turn and face one another for the exchange of vows.
Lynn and I both probably matured a lot over the years. And, you know, to be honest about it, learned to appreciate each other more. Because I was 27 and she was 21.
To renew our vows was another wonderful thing. Because we were younger then, and we're older and mature, more mature now. So...It meant, I feel, those vows that we did at the wedding meant more now than they did on the day we were married.
I, Lynn, take you, Tom, anew.
I, Lynn, take you, Tom,
to be my wedded husband. To continue to have and to hold from this day forward. For better, for worse.For richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part.
这个严肃而又感人的仪式，不久就成了一个轻松欢乐的 party。每个人看上去都在享受着美好的时光，可是 Tom 和 Lynn 好像还没有从惊喜中缓过神来。也许整个庆祝会该由发起者 Chantel 来概括。
The best thing about this event was for everybody to dream that love is possible, and on a long-term relationship, it can happen to you.
在纽约开车逛曼哈顿啊，也是一件非常有情趣的事情。但是呢，因为曼哈顿呢，这个交通非常的不方便，因为车子太多，经常遇到这些 traffic 就是塞车了，所以很多人呢不愿意自己开车。所以这样呢，你可以坐那个 Apple Bus。Apple Bus 呢是一种双层的旅游车，下面呢是那种普通的 bus， 上面呢是开顶的，所以你可以看全部曼哈顿的风景，从中层、上层一直到下层。那这个车子呢也到处停，你也可以随时下来买买东西啊，逛逛看看啊。所以现在呢，你就去看一下这个 Apple Bus 到底是怎么一回事。
是 King Michael James， 是纽约市大苹果旅游公司导游之一。什么是纽约市的大苹果旅游呢？
Apple Tours is a double-decker hop-on hop-off bus service. We give tours of all of New York City, uptown, downtown, and Brooklyn. There's over 68 stops. You'll see all the major attractions. And one of the reasons why it's better to take a double-decker bus than just walk around on your own is because you have a tour guide like myself. Hi, China.Explaining to you where you are, what you're looking at, who lives in each particular neighborhood, how much it costs to live in each particular neighborhood. We also tell you the best places to go, the best places to eat, where to shop, what not to do, what to do, and how to get around the city on your own. All of the buses are open top buses. They're the original double-decker London buses, and they're a lot of fun. As you look at the bus, you can see they're very, very old, and they're a lot of fun, especially when King Michael's the tour guide.
你是如何成为纽约市的一名导游的？
It's interesting. I was walking around the city one day with a friend of mine, and a bus went by us. And I said to my friend, "That's what I want to do." At the time, I was an unemployed actor, and I said, "Once again, that's what I want to do." So I called the company. I came in for an interview, and here I am, 9 years later.
你是怎么得到 Michael 王 King Michael 这个名字的？
They call me the King because I've been a tour guide for over 9 years now. I've given tours to many celebrities. I've appeared in People magazine. I've appeared in Fortune magazine. Just today, I was on a television talk show. I've been on several talk shows. I'm called the King because I'm very good at what they do. At least that's what they tell me. And it's just the name that they gave me many years ago, and I honor that name, so I use it.Today we're going to be taking the downtown ride. We're going to see over 30 different sites. We're going to see Chinatown, Little Italy, Soho, Tribeca, the World Financial District, Midtown, and we're also going to see Times Square, the billboard advertising capital of the world.
好，我们谈的够多了，现在让我们跟着大苹果从上到下的去转一圈吧。
We're going to go down to Central Park South, and we're going to hang a right turn and head on over to the Plaza Hotel, which will be our next stop.
If you look at the next building, the black glass building, that is the Trump International Hotel and Tower. The first 21 floors of that building is a hotel, and then the remaining floors are private condominiums. All the way at the top of Trump International Hotel and Tower is the home of Janet Jackson. If you look in front of us to your left, you'll see some horse and buggy carriages. That's the oldest and most traditional way to visit Central Park. It is my opinion that the best way to see Central Park is by foot.
Hello, ma'am, how are you? Hello, how are you? Yes, how are you, sir? Very well, thank you. After 9 years, how's your sex life?Oh, great. I didn't think you would answer that. Welcome. Look at your wife just turned red. Welcome to New York.
So we're coming up here at the end of Central Park South is the world famous Plaza Hotel. Rooms at the Plaza Hotel start at $295 a night for the least expensive room. And the most expensive suite at the Plaza Hotel is the Presidential Suite, which goes for $17,000 for one night. That suite comes with a Rolls-Royce chauffeur-driven limousine. You get a full staff, and get this, inside of the room, you get a fresh basket of fruit. If you're looking directly in front of us to your right, you're looking at the main entrance of FAO Schwartz. FAO Schwartz is the world's largest toy store. If you are a celebrity hunter, if you like to track down celebrities, that's a great place to start.
你知道第五大道不仅仅是购物的地方吗？
It's one of the most important streets here in New York City because Fifth Avenue separates east from west. On the left side of the bus is the east side of the island, and on the right side of the bus is the west side of the island. If you continue to look to your left, you're looking at Trump Tower, where you'll find the home of Michael Jackson all the way at the top. Look behind you to your left and look into the windows there at Saks Fifth Avenue. Thousands of people line up every year.Just to see the windows of Saks Fifth Avenue. Why? I don't know. I love your gloves and scarf. Where are you guys from?
Ireland.
Oh, welcome to New York. Sing us an Irish song. Welcome to Times Square. Times Square is the billboard advertising capital of the world. This is where you'll find more billboards in one place than any other place in the world.
这个地区过去是纽约时报的老巢。
That is how Times Square got its name, Times Square. If you come to Times Square at night, which is one of the best times to come to Times Square, you'll see it all lit up in light. Over 3 million light bulbs to light up Times Square. That's a lot of light bulbs. Once we bypass the garbage district, we're going to go into the wholesale district. We're going to go into the wholesale district, and from the wholesale district, we're going to go into the Flatiron district.But between the garbage district and the wholesale district, we're going to see 34th Street, which is Midtown's premier shopping district. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Empire State Building. Once again, the Empire State Building was built in 1929. We're going to take 5th Avenue down to 14th Street. And this is actually one of my favorite parts of the tour.You will be able to see the entire width of the island. 14th Street is the widest point of the island. It is the street that gives New York City its width. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Greenwich Village. Greenwich Village is the home of many poets, actors, actresses, musicians, writers, dancers, artists, and tour guides. If you look in front of you to your right, right here on the corner is the Lemongrass Grill. That's one of my favorite Thai food restaurants.Cab Caliente directly in front of us on your right. The food here is terrible, but they make great margaritas. If you continue to look to your left, you'll see an archway. That archway was built to commemorate the 100th anniversary of the inauguration of George Washington. Close to 40 years ago, a very popular African-American boy grew up on this street. Today, he is known around the world, even in China. He is known around the world by thousands and thousands of people.Grew up in this building right here to your left, just behind us. He is known around the world by thousands and thousands of people as King Michael.
Hey!
If you look to your left, ladies and gentlemen, you'll see a statue of Fiorello LaGuardia. He was the mayor of New York from 1934 to 1945. He was well loved by the immigrants. During his reign as mayor of New York City, that's when thousands and thousands of immigrants were coming through Ellis Island. This street is named after him.LaGuardia Place. If you look up the street to your left, ladies and gentlemen, this is a typical residential Soho street. Look at the buildings here, the beautiful colors. At one time, these were all factories. The factories here in New York City can now be found in Queens. Coming up, our next stop will be Chinatown. Chinatown is the best place in New York City to buy a genuine, authentic imitation Rolex watch. Over 80,000 people shop in Chinatown daily.If you look to your left, ladies and gentlemen, you're looking at one of the most popular tourist attractions in New York City. You're looking at the Brooklyn Bridge. The Brooklyn Bridge here on your left was built in 1876. Okay, our next stop, ladies and gentlemen, will be the World Trade Center Twin Towers. Your street coming up is the New York Stock Exchange and the world-famous Wall Street. If you look to your right, ladies and gentlemen, you're looking at Grand Central Station. Grand Central Station is the oldest subway station in New York City, and it is the largest subway station in the United States.
每天一遍又一遍地看着同样的景色，你会对纽约市不感到无聊吗？
I could never get bored with New York City. As you know, New York City is one of the greatest cities in the world. There's so much to do here. I have tried living in other cities, and that is when I find myself bored. Here in New York City, there's so much to do. And now that I'm a tour guide, I'm constantly learning more and more about the city every day. I know the best places to go, the best things to do, when to do it. So I have a great time all the time.
One good thing about New York, all my friends in China, nobody cares what you look like. So come, have a great time. Be yourself. Come with your purple hair.
哟，一个小时过得是不是很快，一转眼就过去了。下一集啊，我们还有更精彩的内容等着你来看。我们会带你去看纽约一家化妆品店，这店呢很有意思，进去的时候啊，你先不用买，只要是试到你满意你才买，是不是好玩？在美国俚语中 ring cats and dogs 到底是什么意思呢？看了才会知道。在横穿美国的旅途中，我们又有新的发现，是什么样的发现呢？下一集你就知道了。好了，谢谢收看，下一集再见。
人生四季一场梦，梦到春天一朵花开放在你的脸上，那我岁月灿烂。人生四季一场梦。